Good morning, Facebook. What's happening, everybody? Jamie and I are just eating a little breakfast. We're eating a little mashed avocado. We're going on a bike ride. So I wanted to do a quick Facebook Live on the best type of potato to make mashed potatoes. Ooh, Jamie, that sauce is spicy. Ooh, Jamie used some of this Nando's peri peri sauce. Wow, is it spicy. Jamie likes spicy. Jamie's a person like spice in the family. I'll eat Frank's, and that's about it. All right, so it is Saturday morning. I want to do a quick Facebook Live here on the best potato to use to make mashed potatoes. People think you need to peel potatoes. People buy certain potatoes. I'm going to talk about in my experience, and I got this because of being a chef apprentice at the Greenbrier in West Virginia in the mid-90s, and we had a book by Joel Robuchon, and it was Paris Michelin 3-star restaurant, and he was known to have the best mashed potatoes in the world, and the chef I was working for at the time really studied the technique and the potatoes, and these were the type of potatoes that we actually made at the Greenbrier in the tavern room when I worked there, and everybody was like, these are the best mashed potatoes hands down. So I'm going to talk about my experience with mashed potatoes. Before I do that, first off, bourbon and blues tonight. Tonight, come by, get your samples of Mr. Peabody bourbon and rye, get your kit to make in Manhattan. Peter Peabody from Mr. Peabody will be on the Zoom, virtual Zoom. So it's a blue bourbon and blues hangout tonight, virtual hangout at 8:30. It's $25 without food, $45 with food. With food, you get our brisket entree, which is usually $27, $26. So it's a really good deal. You get a dessert that Jamie made. She made these little chocolate bourbon tartlets. And you get a local cheese. We get to go through the bourbon and the whiskey. It's really a fun night. We've been doing these the last several Saturday nights with great success. Different, we've been doing wines. Last week we did tequila and rock and roll. So it is awesome. So 25 or 45, 647-3000. Don't call yet though, because Jamie and I are going for a bike ride. We're gonna be gone for a couple of hours. We gotta get out and enjoy this. I went on a bike ride yesterday up Wintish Road and into Greenfield Park and back down into Ellenville, 12-mile loop with a lot of elevation gain. It felt really great. It is beautiful out. All right, everybody, thanks for tuning in. If you're dropping a comment, if you're watching live, drop a comment, hashtag live. If it's on the replay, hashtag replay. If you like mashed potatoes, drop a comment, say yes, love mashed potatoes. This one's for you, because I am holding the potatoes here that make the best mashed potatoes. And again, this is from my experience of working at the Greenbrier, based upon the works of Joel Robuchon. His restaurant in Paris is Michelin 3-star. So Joel Robuchon, who has passed on, he was one of the most famous French chefs out there in the 90s, 2000s. The guy was just a pure genius when it came to food, French food. And his restaurants were bar none. I mean, just insane. They were the top in the world, his restaurants. So he had in one of his cookbooks how to make mashed potatoes. And here's the secret to making mashed potatoes. Somebody the other day came and bought potatoes from us. And these are the potatoes we sell. These are Yukon B potatoes. B means the size. A C would be a bigger one. An A would be a slightly smaller one. So that's why they go A, B's, and C's. Now, he said to me, he goes, Marcus, I could never peel these small potatoes. And it dawned on me, I need to make a video on mashed potatoes. Folks, you do not peel potatoes to make mashed potatoes. That's part of the terroir, that's part of the flavor, that's part of the flavor profile, that's part of what makes mashed potatoes great, is the skins. Now, you can't just use any potatoes, because certain potato skins especially are just not as likable as others. So the smaller the potato, the better off you are, because it has more skin surface. The more skin surface you have, the more flavor you're gonna have, the more depth of the potato. All right, a lot of mashed potatoes, folks, they take these russet Burbank potatoes, these Dakotas or Burbanks, russet Burbanks, those Idaho potatoes that are oval-shaped. They're oval-shaped, very high starch content, not much flavor, they fry very well. The reason why they taste good for french fries is because you add salt. You would not eat a fried potato if there was not salt on it. It's not that flavorful. Then you add ketchup, salt and ketchup, now you're talking to most Americans, like, okay, these are french fries. Or you add some other stuff on it, like cheese or whatever. and make fancy fries. But if you just took that russet Burbank, the Dakota, so it's also called a Dakota, it's another varietal, that oval-shaped potato, and if you peel it and mash it without adding anything to it, you'll notice there's no flavor to it. There's not much of a flavor to that potato. Potatoes like these, red potatoes, Yukon potatoes, fingerling potatoes, Russian banana potatoes, French fingerling potatoes, all these small potatoes, these heirloom varietal potatoes, have much more flavor. They don't have a high starch content. They have a higher moisture content, which is why you cannot fry this potato. This potato does not fry well because of the moisture content. So you take these potatoes, smaller the better, do not peel them. You boil them, don't steam them. I know some people who still steam potatoes, especially in the restaurant industry. It's a fine process to take these potatoes and pop them in a pan and pop them in one of those industrial steamers and you steam them. Not suggested. When you cook potatoes in water, potatoes are a sponge. That is your opportunity to add flavor to the potato when you're cooking the potato. That's when you add your rosemary, your thyme, your garlic, your salt in the cooking water. Because potatoes, again, are a sponge. If you, and I've done this before, I've done this with chefs before, and this was done to me as a young chef apprentice. The chef cooked two pots of potatoes. One, the potato, the water had seasoning. The other pot had no water, just had water and no seasoning. We tasted, and it was a world of difference. This is why they say when a soup is too salty, you throw a potato in, because a potato is a sponge. It will absorb flavor. So if your soup is too salty, you throw a potato in, it's supposed to absorb the salt and then ease back on the salt for you. So potatoes are sponges. They will take flavor. Small potatoes, more skin contact, more flavor, more terroir, more earth. Okay, remember the Dakota potato? That's just a bland potato to begin with, the rest of Burbank, the French fried potato. You take these, you boil them, you add the flavorings, then you strain them. And the key to making a good mashed potato, non-glutinous, now you know sometimes they get a little sticky on you. Do not do it with a machine. Do not let the potatoes get cold. The potatoes get cold, they do not get as creamy. They get gluey. When they get cold, they get gluey, not creamy. So you take these potatoes when they're hot and you put them through like a mill, like a ricing mill or a potato masher by hand, and you work them as quick as possible. And then you adjust your salt. Some people add cream. Some people will add butter, a lot of butter. Joel Robuchon, in fact, would add an insane amount of butter. He added probably one part butter to one part potato. And when he put his potatoes in a plate, you could not put them in a plate. They would actually just ooze down, so they would have to be served in a bowl. So that's what made his potatoes really famous, was the amount of high-quality French butter that he would put into the potatoes. So that would make an insane mashed potato. That is why Joel Robuchon was known to have the best potatoes in the world, and he had it to his science. One trick that he did, which I was not a fan of, he would cook the potatoes. He made them to order. He made the mashed potatoes to order. So he cooked the whole batch of potatoes and cooled them. And each time an order would come in to his restaurant in Paris, the cook in the back on that station would make the mashed potatoes to order, which means they would take the potatoes for that, mash them, butter them, and serve them. The one thing he did that I did not like was, it's a great concept to do that. One thing he did I did not like was he put the cold potatoes that were cooked into the microwave. I'm not a fan of a microwave. It does funky stuff to your food. It alters the DNA. It ruptures the DNA. There's no long-term studies on what the effects are of extended microwave use on food and how this food goes into your body and what happens. So I'm not a fan of the microwave. All right, a lot of people aren't as well. I don't own one. I haven't owned one at home for years. I don't own one in the restaurant. I've never owned one in the restaurant. But that's one thing Joel Robuchon did because of ease. And that would just bring it right back hot, and then they make it to order and send it out. So again, to recap this, you need to use an heirloom varietal potatoes, Yukons, French fingerlings, Russian bananas, crescents, German butterballs. German butterballs are awesome potatoes. If you ever find a German butterball, get it. Make mashed potatoes out of them. The smaller the potato, the more skin it has. You do not peel. You want the skin in for flavor. It's terroir. It's earth tones. It actually provides depth, flavors, characteristics to your mashed potatoes. Unlike that oval Burbank potato, Dakota potato, russet Burbank potato you make French fries with, there's no flavor in that. It's a high, very high starch profile. These are low starch, high moisture, all right? You can cook them in water, add flavorings in the water, you mash them when they're hot, and do not use a machine. If you were to take this potato, boil it and throw it into a food processor, the S blade, and turn, you'd have nothing but one big gluey mess, and it would be a disaster. So do not do that. You have to work these by hand while they're hot. Add your butter, your olive oil, whatever you want to do. We do a version at the restaurant with these where we take olive oil, roasted garlic, and we mash them, keep the skins in contact, a little larger. It's more, it's not really a true mashed or potato puree. It's more like a crushed potato. And that is our version of mashed potatoes. So olive oil in at the end as a seasoning, roasted garlic, whole cloves in, and we mash them in there. And that's, if you've ever had our potato cakes, our mashed potato cakes, on our steaks, that's exactly what that is, all right? So everybody have an amazing day. Jamie and I are gonna go for a bike ride. We're gonna finish our avocado. We're having some avocado for breakfast and we're going for a nice bike ride, about, I don't know, 12, 15 miles. So we gotta get going. All right, everybody, enjoy your day. Bourbon and blues tonight. Our grocery list is, run like the wind race tomorrow. We can't meet on the streets here and 300 of us run, but if you wanna run tomorrow and donate money, we are taking $10 and $25 donations. It's on the EllenvilleRunLikeTheWind.com website. When you donate, even as little as $10, you get a free pizza from Aroma Time when we're back open and normal, which hopefully will be at some point this summer. Because our fire pit, our garden is looking great, and we need people out there. We need people in the restaurant. We need music back here. We got a lot of cool plans. The menu's changing as early as Monday or Tuesday. The menu's pretty much finalized. We just have not executed in the kitchen, but new menu, lower prices, tapas style food. It's gonna be amazing. Farm to table tapas. All right, folks, gotta get going. Everybody, thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it. Anne Marie, Michael's on again from the West Coast. It's early there. Joey's on, Steve, Tom, Brenda. All right, folks, thanks for tuning in. And leave any comments or questions. Our full grocery list is on our website. Today's $9.99 special is barbecued chicken, slow-smoked barbecued chicken with organic, local pinto beans and organic coleslaw, $9.99. Things like that are gonna be staying on our menu. That's the exciting part. You're gonna be able to walk in here and get food like that for $9.99 even after this whole mess is over, all right? So we'll talk to you later.